Here at eFIXX, we love products that are keeping up to date with the rapidly changing EV market, and we've got one in the form of the EV tower here. I said previously, the charging unit we're installing at Lineside Studio wouldn't float in thin air, so we've supported our 22 kilowatt three-phase CTEK commercial EV charger against this EV tower. It's jam-packed full of great features, as well as ones that future-proof your installation moving forward, and we're going to take a look at all of those in this video. Let's start at the base of our EV tower, which is detachable from the post, which is a great advantage to us as electricians because it means we can leave that base on site with the civils team, so as they're digging out and pouring their concrete, they know exactly where to leave maybe the threaded rod poking through that concrete base in order to secure it, or they could use the thunderbolts provided by EV Tower in order that we can fix it. We didn't choose that as a solution here at Lineside Studios. We chose to use EV blocks, and the EV blocks have a plate that is removable from the top of that, meaning we could take both that and the base plate from the EV Tower to our workshop and drill it out and bolt it into position. And then we brought it back in here and we dropped the remaining part of the tower in. However, you might be thinking, if I'm on site and there is a ducting or a cable already poking through my pre-poured concrete block, how am I going to make sure I can navigate that through in order to fit my base plate? And the answer to that's around the back. Nice attention to detail here around the back of the base plate. We've got this slot, so in order that where our cable is, say, coming through in a ducting or just poking out through our concrete block, we can just slide the base plate into position, and then we can just finish it off with these nice caps over the top of those fixings. Here on the side of the EV tower is a plate which is removed when you take off these security screws, where you could house such things as RCD protection. We know that RCD protection isn't always built into every EV charger, or maybe an isolating switch. And in Ireland, it is a requirement to have an isolating switch local to your EV charging point. And we know as the regulations keep changing, this is something that might happen here for us as well. So working up further at the back of the EV tower, we see a solid insert here that can be removed, and a cable connects it at this point, and you can insert a grommet to protect that cable as it comes out. Also, we've got another point here where a cable can come into an EV charger. Now, you might be thinking, well, that's odd because we're on the back side of the tower. Well, that's because you can actually install EV charging points on both sides, and we'll explore that a little bit further as we move into the video. The EV tower also allows us to add accessories, and on this side here, we've bolted on a bracket that means this lead won't be laying all over the floor when not in use. It's simply curled up and hooked onto here. The other side, we have an accessory that will hold the end of our EV charger in place when we're not using it. So I mentioned there that you can install another EV charger on the opposite side of the EV tower. Now, it doesn't mean you have to match the one you've got on the front. So what I've done is I've selected this plate here that matches my Easee EV charger. And it's a simple process in order to install it. Two bolts hold the plate into place, and already pre-drilled onto that plate are the four fixing positions that I need for my Easee EV charger. Wow, that is simple. So I've installed it, the EV tower, currently with one charger on the front, but in the future I can add more to it. But let's think again, maybe that the CTEK EV charger needs replacing in the future. The tower will stay in place, the charger can come off, you can replace the plate with the appropriate one for the new charger being installed, and you go again. There are loads of different plates that EV Tower make to fit the EV chargers, but we know that market is rapidly changing. So I will leave a link to their website in the description below so you can check out the latest plates that they are currently making. With all the great features that EV Tower offers, I now want to protect it from those overexcited EV drivers that spot a charging unit available for a charge and come charging in, possibly in reverse, not noticing the wonderful tower and back into it. In order to protect it, we can use these barriers that I've got in front of me. But what's really good is that we can add our own brand into it. We've added CTEK to this one, but think about the business that you're working in. Your business branding could also appear on the barrier. If you want to catch up on the full series of how we installed this three-phase commercial EV charger from CTEK here at Lineside Studios, I'll leave that playlist in the eye above my head, as well as a link in the description below. But as always, we're interested in your comments, your feedback, and your stories. Have you got any great stories about EV cars that are reversed into walls, or maybe into posts, into charging units? Please leave them in the comments below, and I'd love to read them all. Is there anything we've missed out of the playlist that you think should be featured, and we'll go back and put it in? Also, can you tell us how you're installing in commercial installations your EV chargers? Are you using the EV tower? Are you using something else? We'd be interested in all of those comments, and I'll try and get back to as many as I can.